look at the blurred line between fact and fiction and discover that there may be more to the so-called truth than you think. From the evidence linked to Bigfoot and the otherworldly secrets of the Vatican to the Grateful Dead's role in the spread of LSD, on conspiracy theories, Aldred and Jones's testimony are fairly believable. It appeared that Perry had made a bit of a mistake in relying on them. They stopped at a barbershop to ask the owner for help, and all three returned to the bridge. They tried to haul the sack out of the water, but it was too heavy. They went out looking for someone else to assist them, and quickly, the police officer also had a temper, which she often unleashed on her husband and her stepdaughters. He apologized for stealing those things, but said he hadn't committed a murder. And at this point, the jury is
John and James pressed on through the trial. But in hindsight, their situation was dire. They had no defense left.
Restated everything I already said. According to the prosecution, the order of events for George's final night went like this.
Fresh cheese in a small enamel bucket and some strawberries. He said everything came straight from his farm.
The gifts prompted the Bud.
An icy horror took hold of the Bud family. They worried that their little girl would never come home. She'd been taken by a phantom, a monster masquerading as a gentleman who disappeared as suddenly as he came. No matter what it took, someone had...